Blackstone Publishing presents Die Me a River by Denise Swanson. This book is read by Christine Leto. Chapter 1. Too Busy Thinking About My Baby. School psychologist Skye Denison-Boyd stopped pacing, tucked a stray curl into her messy bun, and plopped onto one of the chairs facing Homer Napick's desk. She'd been waiting 15 minutes, and the high school principal hadn't yet graced her with his presence. Officially, Skye was on maternity leave for another 2 months, but between the frantic plea from her intern, Piper Townsend, and the incensed call from Homer, she'd agreed to come to the school for a meeting. It had taken her a couple of hours to arrange for a babysitter, pack up the twins' paraphernalia, and find something other than yoga pants that fit her post-pregnancy body. Skye wasn't clear about the details of the actual problem. Both parties had been too incoherent for her to understand their rambling. But from what she could gather, Homer was trying to slip something unethical past Piper. Doubtlessly, he was hoping that the intern's inexperience would allow him to play fast and loose with the rules and regulations governing public education. Although Skye could have asked the co-op psychologist assigned to supervise Piper's internship during Skye's absence to handle the matter, she couldn't in good conscience turn her back on either of those women. Dealing with Homer was more of an art than a science, and expecting someone unfamiliar with his peculiarities to handle the situation would be heartless. The Scumble River School District belonged to the Stanley County Special Education Cooperative, an entity that furnished the district with programs and personnel and managed the bureaucratic red tape of special education funding. However, the co-op psychologist had never dealt with the likes of Homer, and Skye was afraid the woman would cut and run if the principal was his usual obnoxious self. Then there was the poor intern who might just decide she'd chosen the wrong profession if Skye didn't help her navigate the rocky roads of Homer's fiefdom. Piper hadn't yet grasped that, while the high school principal was indeed an agent of the devil, his duties were largely ceremonial. Interrupting Skye's musings, the door banged open, and a gruff voice that scraped like a knife being sharpened at a grinding stone yelled, "It's about time you got here. Do you think I have all day to waste on this?" Skye's skin crawled as she took a calming breath. Nothing would change Homer at this stage in his career, which, fingers crossed, was darn close to retirement. After working with him for nearly 7 years, Skye's strategy was similar to the winners on her favorite reality TV show: outwit, outplay, outlast. Pasting a cheery expression on her face, she crossed her ankles and then said, "I guess I could have brought the twins with me and breastfed them while we talked. I'm sure you wouldn't have minded helping me burp them." She gestured at his huge desk and added, "And that would probably make a pretty good changing table for their dirty diapers." Homer glowered at Skye, stomped past her, and selected a Long John from the box of donuts on the credenza. Next, he popped a pod into the Keurig and waited for it to brew. Once the coffee was finished, he grabbed the mug, moved to his massive leather chair, and eased his bulk onto the cushioned seat. The principal's office was larger than many of the school's classrooms, and its furnishings were top of the line. How much of the school's budget had Homer appropriated for his grandiose display of power? After taking a healthy gulp of the hot beverage, he said, "You wouldn't have had to come in at all if you would have just ordered Paisley to stop defying me and quit questioning my decisions." "Piper," Skye corrected. "How many times do I have to tell you her name is Piper?"
"Who in the hell names their kid something like that?"
Homer rolled his eyes.
"Is her father the Pied Piper of Hamelin or something?"
"Really? At your age, you've never heard of the actress Piper Laurie?" Skye raised her brows in question, but when Homer didn't respond, she said, "Whatever. It's a pretty name and it's hers, so remember it." This was exactly why Skye and her husband Wally were having such a hard time selecting names for their twins. The babies were going on 5 weeks old, and they still hadn't agreed on what to call them, a fact that had made it very difficult to leave the hospital. The nurses had driven Skye and Wally nuts trying to get them to choose names and fill out the paperwork. They'd practically had to sneak out of the place to take the babies home.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.